Hey guys, so today is Thursday the 11th and it is like 10 after 5 p.m. How is it that late? Oh my gosh, the day has gotten away from me. I've been in a bad mood today, but I'm in a better one now because I decided to be, right? I've been stressed out, guys. I really, really have. And I'll just go ahead and tell you a little bit about that. Our heat pump, our heating and cooling unit, whatever, I don't even know what it's called, the proper terminology, but our heating and cooling unit for this floor of the house quit working yesterday. Thank God it didn't get too hot because I cannot deal with the heat. Like, I cannot deal with it. And it never fails. Your heat pump never goes out in the wintertime. It's always in the summer when it's hot, right? So anyways, you know, we are blessed in that this room, I don't know if I've ever even shown this on a vlog. So this is like the middle floor of the house, I guess, because we do have the basement. The upstairs is open. So all I did, oh my goodness, I forgot to kick that back up. I turned the upstairs unit to 68 yesterday. And where that's open, it really did keep this floor cool as well. So the hottest that it got down here last night was 73. That's not that bad. But there was no, you know the difference when you have your heat pump on, like your central air, I guess. There's air circulation, there's movement, and you know, it was just stale air and yuck. I mopped up here earlier today. Yay. So yeah. Oh, guys, it's been a bad day with her too. Doris, what happened to your ponytail? We need to fix it. She messed it up a while ago. But like, even before we ever moved into this house, we had to replace the unit upstairs. And we knew both units are the same age, right? So when that one went out yesterday, I mean, we were like, David was here. He was like, we're probably going to have to just get a new heating and cooling unit for this floor too. You know, because we just figured it's probably give out as well, you know? So I was stressed out about that. Poor Piper has been so bad yesterday. Well, really the last 3 days, I guess. I mean, and when I say bad, I don't know if you all really realize what I'm saying. Like, has to be near me 24 hours a day. Like, I don't get a break from this. 24 hours a day. When I sit in the living room, she has to be in the chair beside of me. Both hands have to be on her. If I'm, like, holding my phone going through it, she'll put her snout under my phone and flip it up. Like, she don't want anything in my hand. If I hold the TV remote, she flips it out of my hand. That's where we eat dinner. Like, if I have my plate of food, she constantly has her head under my plate trying to flip it out of my hand. Like, I can't do anything. Nothing. And it's just been, I mean, it's really, really getting to me. It really is. Not having a break from it. Hyperventilating off while I'm trying to sleep. Trembling so hard she shakes the bed, blowing her hot air in my face. You know, I can't, I'm a very light sleeper. I can't sleep through that. So we're up all night. It's going on all day. Like, it's so much. I went out to check the mail yesterday, or hey God, I can't keep up the days of the week. Day before yesterday, I don't know. And I walked from the front door to the mailbox, which you see here, okay? So that short of distance. And when I walked out to the mailbox, like, I could hear her. And like, if you had been going by my house, you would have sworn someone was in here torturing her. I mean, wailing. And I was like, and all I did was walk to the mailbox. Like, her separation anxiety is that bad. When I went to the grocery store, and she seen me walk into the garage, she scratched the door. Like, I don't know what to do. And, you know, we're out all this money. I mean, we're talking over $700 this month for her. And it would be different if we had, like, some really definitive answers and treatment and things were changing. We don't. You know, we found out she had the heart murmur, but it's nothing too severe that it needs medication. Her thyroid is a little bit hyperactive. It's nothing that requires any medication. So, 700 and some odd dollars later, and all we have is Prozac, you know, and it's not in its therapeutic level yet, and it's just, it's really taking a toll on me. It truly, truly is. So then I started thinking about vacation this summer. We take my niece and nephew and my mom to Florida every year, and we've done this since the kids were really, really small. And I'm like, who's going to come and take care of my dog? Like, before, everywhere we've ever went, this hasn't ever been an issue. Piper is 8 years old, you know? This has never been an issue. This is a new thing. And me, the person who loves her more than anybody, like, it's killing me. Like, I know there's not going to be anybody who will come in here and want to deal with that, you know? Before, when we lived in Prestonsburg, we had friends that would, like, come and take care of our animals for us. We don't have anybody here. So, the only trip we've taken together, I went to Paris and London, but David was here and he was able to take care of the animals. But we went to Vegas in, was it March, I guess? And my cousin Hayden came and stayed with the girls. They're touring in Germany right now. He's a musician. And he and my cousin Kenny are touring in Germany right now. So I've not even asked him yet, but I can almost tell you for sure, he's not going to want to deal with this, you know? And I don't know what to do with her. I mean, really my only option would be to board her at a vet's office because she takes famotidine daily for her stomach that's Pepcid. And then she has to have her Prozac now. She can't be without her medication. And I don't know. I think the only place that's going to be equipped to deal with her is a vet's office. But I don't know. You know, I still need somebody to come here and, like, check in on the cats. And I don't know what we're going to do. And then, you know, Darcy, it's expensive to board an animal like that, you know. And I don't know what we're going to do. Tell me what to do, guys. I don't know. Give me some ideas. But, you know, I told my mom last night, I was talking to her and I was like, I might just have to stay home this year. You know, you all might have to go on family vacation without me. You know, I don't know what else to do. And of course she was like, no. So I woke up this morning and I was just overwhelmed. I really was. And normally in life, I don't get stressed out about things that are out of my control. I can't control what's going on with the heat pump. I can't control what's going on with Piper. All I can try to do is fix those things, right? So we had a heating and cooling company come out this morning, and it was actually a very small fix. For some reason, it threw the breaker, and we can't figure out why. But the guy somehow tested it, and he said that it should not have thrown the breaker. So he said that it's probably a weak breaker. My stepdad's going to come Tuesday and change it for me. But the air's back on. It's very cool in here, so all is well with that again. And, you know, with Piper, all I can do is just keep giving her her medication and comfort her the best that I can. And about that, you know, I thought, a while ago I was sitting there and I was just holding her and petting her. And I thought, you know, there will come a day when I will give anything for her to be needing me and to be pawing at me and wanting me to comfort her. So, I'm not going to complain about that. I'm not. And I pray that I can stay patient with her. Because I do. I love you with my whole heart. I love you with my whole heart. I do. It's my baby. Yes. So, that's where we're at. That's what we've been doing. She is a mommy's girl. So in case you missed it, I mentioned this hair mask by Suave in my April favorite and in my hair transformation video. Guys, I love this mask. It says
that it's salon proven to moisturize as well as a Veda dry remedy. I love this mask. It is about $3 on Amazon. It was $2.79 at Meijer. So I did get me a couple more of those. And as you can see, and I still have the one that I'm using here. That's my other favorite mask, the My Amazing Secret Restore and Shine. But I have used the Neutrogena body oil for years, probably 10 or 15 years. And I was almost out. And I like the big bottles, but they only had this like 8.5 fluid ounce bottle at Meijer. The other one was sold out, so I went ahead and got me one of those. And I got me another Batiste, because that's like my cheap, affordable, everyday dry shampoo. I try to use my more expensive ones for fancier occasions. But since I love this so much, they had these, the shampoo and conditioner in the same line, the Almond and Shea Butter. And it also says salon proven to moisturize as well as Aveda dry remedy. And these are the big pump top bottles. And for this set, it was $5.79. So I figured we could try that. And then my friend Dana on Facebook told me that I really needed to try the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation because she has oily skin and she said that it works really good for her. But unless you've got crazy oily skin and it works for you, I'm very hesitant to try new foundations. That being said, I would really like to try the Dior Forever Foundation. And there was something else. Oh, this is the Lancome. Is it Tint or Taint? It looks like Taint. I don't know. On the right side of my cheek. The foundation sample that they sent from Sephora was so small, it only did half my face. So on this side over here, that is the Lancome. This side is Milani. So I'll see how that looks tonight. And then I just wanted to show you all, I completely used up my Timeless 20% C plus E plus Ferulic Acid Serum. Okay, I love this stuff and I have ordered yet another bottle. It hasn't made it yet, but this didn't oxidize. It stayed completely good. I store it in the refrigerator, throwing it away. What? But I do store it in the refrigerator, so every morning, I only use it in the morning. Every morning when I wash my face, I come on into the kitchen and I put on my serum and start my coffee and give this one her morning medicine. So I love that stuff. Don't want to be without it. I already placed another order and it will be here tomorrow. Can I set you down for a minute? Oh. It's my mom. Oh Lord. Another kitten showed up at her house. And she's like I am. Everything that shows up, we take it and have it like spayed or neutered and try to find it a good home. But I mean, I tell you what, especially back there in the country where we're from, if people know you'll take care of an animal, they set them out at your house like they do. So anyways, for this Wet n Wild foundation, it seems like this one does oxidize on a lot of people and it turns darker. So I got Buff Bisque. Most foundation colors, like I can make it work. I really can. Like with bronzer and concealer and by the time you get all that crap on, very little of your foundation shows anyways, right? So anyways, heck, we'll try it out. Maybe I'll try it tomorrow. I don't think I'm gonna film a video on it, but we'll try it out in a vlog type video. Ooh, yes, I got UPS packages, just one. Okay, so that's just my two pack of my Sani solution for the Cat Genie. That's our litter box, quit barking. That, okay, and whenever I put my last cartridge in, it's just this soap cartridge. Whenever I put the last one in, I make sure I go ahead and order a couple of more. That way, whenever that one goes out, I've always got more on hand. Oh gosh, I'm sleepy, guys. Y'all want to see what came in my Target beauty box? I think I actually really will use the coupon that come in this one. There's some stuff at Target I probably need to get. So, this is the May beauty box, I guess. We got a Nexus shampoo and conditioner, and it's just the little packets. Oh no, it's little bottles. How cute. It's the Therapy shampoo and humectress conditioner, so really cute. We also got a Nexus Vital 8-in-1, or Vital, I don't know if you can see that. It's a hair mask with coconut oil, soybean oil, and keratin. And that is in this big kind of thick pouch. I think that will do at least 2 or 3 masks. We got an Acure Pore Minimizing Red Clay Mask. All up on anything that says pore. Oh, pore minimizing or pore clarifying? Okay, this says pore minimizing, but it's actually pore clarifying. We got a pack of Nubian Heritage Bath Bombs that have coconut oil and papaya. And we got 2 of those. That sounds wonderful. It also has vanilla extract in it. We got a full-size Wet n Wild Mega Lash Liquid Lipstick. And we got the color Nice to Fuchsia 927B. I've never tried these liquid catsuits, so I really do look forward to trying that. We got a Vichy pore purifying clay mask, and it's a white clay mask. So that sounds wonderful. Can't wait to try that. And we got a Guess fragrance for women. Guess Dare. I probably won't use that. And last but not least, we got a Soap and Glory Flake Away Body Polish. And it's a body polish with shea butter, almond oil, peach seed powder, and sugar. And I did smell this. It's quite a good sized little tub. I did smell this. It's not as good smelling as, say, the breakfast scrub, which smells like food that you could eat. But this does smell good. And I love a sugar scrub. So, lots of good stuff. You know what? Let's just try this liquid lipstick on for size. How's that? Woo! Gonna be looking rough. All right. Have y'all ever tried the liquid, what's it called? Liquid catsuit? Liquid catsuit lipsticks? Oh crap. I've made a mess. Alright. It's beginning to dry down. We'll see. Alright. Now I'm going upstairs to. Come on. Come on. Come on. Me and my shadow, we're going upstairs to publish. I really want to go to Walmart and get me some of that Cokie makeup. Get me some Cokie lipsticks. I hear wonderful things about it. I just don't want to drive to Walmart. It's bad. So I just had a sandwich for dinner. This is why I hate liquid lipsticks. I'm a total gloss girl, honey. Or a traditional lipstick out of the bullet, right?